You're working on a new project in Java and you need to send an email. How do you do it? Well, you can always reach for the Java Mail API, but I'm going to show you a different way to do it, one that I think has a lot of advantages, and that's by using a service called SendGrid. Now, yes, this is a service you will need to pay for, but you can start for free, test it out, see if you like it, see if it's worth it, but I definitely think it's worth it. And so I think SendGrid has a few advantages over Java's built-in Java Mail. First off, you get better deliverability rates. It's really hard to make sure with all the rules in place around sending emails that your emails are getting delivered. So if these are mission critical emails that need to get delivered, we want to make sure that we are using a service that allows us to deliver them. Through that, we get some rich analytics and tracking as well. You need to be able to track what is going on in the system, how many were sent, how many were actually delivered, and we get a whole bunch of analytics around sending those emails. There's a modern REST API. There's also SDKs for multiple languages, including Java. It's a really easy to implement. There's a dependency that we'll include in our application, and really easy to get up and running with that API. Finally, better spam handling. When we are sending email, we want to make sure that this is not going into spam, and there are ways to kind of handle that. So I'm a big fan of SendGrid. I've set up a new account so we can kind of walk through it and test it out, but we're going to build a project in Java, and we're going to see how we can send an email using SendGrid. All right, so here we are over on the website. This is SendGrid brought to you by Twilio. Email API for developers by developers. Create an email program with an email API trusted by top brands to send at scale. So you can go in here, you can start for free, you can check out the pricing to see if it's something that's going to work for you. But again, start for free, go in there, create an account, you'll get an API key. You have to like set up like where you're sending from. I just used a Gmail for this account. It says that you should probably use like a trusted domain name. So if you have your own domain name, your own email for that, go ahead and use that. So if you scroll down here, you can see trusted by some very big companies. How it works. Again, email deliverability is very important. We want to make sure that our emails are getting sent. Some different use cases for it, just alerts and notifications. You're in an app and you need to send a notification, fine. Marketing and promotions. You want to send mass emails about something that's going on, or you want to do verifications and identity. We'll actually use this in a further Spring Security tutorial later when we use one-time token authentication. So this is kind of a precursor to that. Then you go in, again, lots of features. It's not just sending email. Once you get into that dashboard, you can see like all of the things that you can do with it. You can do like automations. You can do email testing, validations. They have some nice email templates, etc. So there's a whole lot going on. This is a really good place to start. The quick start documentation, the API reference, there's some blog articles. This is a really good place to start. But if you have not signed up for an account yet, go ahead and pause this video. Sign up for free. I didn't put in a credit card or anything. They aren't sponsoring this video, although they could. And you can just get started right away, get an API key, and now we can start to build this out. So with that, let's head over to an IDE and create a new Java project. All right, so to create my new Java project, I'm using IntelliJ. You can use whatever IDE or text editor you're most productive in. It's going to be the same no matter what. And we're going to create a new project. I'm going to go ahead and put this in my dev Java folder, and we're going to call this SendGrid. I'm going to use Maven because we need a build tool here. We are going to include a dependency. So the best way to do that is by using a build tool, declaring a dependency, and having the project kind of include that for you. So I'm going to use Maven JDK 23, although you don't need to be on 23 to get this going. So that's all I need. I'm going to create this project, and we'll open it up here in the IDE. Now, the first thing we're going to need is the dependencies. So in Maven, we do this by declaring a dependencies block. And I'll go ahead and get me out of the way so we can go ahead and see this. So I'm going to declare this dependency, com.sendgrid, SendGrid Java, and the current version, I think, is actually 4.10.3. I believe there's a version 5 out there that is not yet stable. So if you're watching this later, just check to see what the current version is. Okay, so with that in place, we have the dependencies that we need. And we need to basically start by creating some type of email service so that we can go ahead and send our emails. So I'm going to start by creating a new Java class. I'm going to call this an email service, right? And we'll start by declaring a API key. So I'm going to say private static final. And actually, this doesn't even need to be static final string SendGrid API key. And I'm going to go ahead and grab my API key, and I will go ahead and delete this after we are done shooting this video so that you cannot use it. So don't try and use this one. Make sure you are using your own. And now we just need to create a method to send an email. So I'm going to say public void send email. And to send an email, we are going to need who we're going to send it to, what is the subject of the email, and what is the content of the email. All right. So now I am going to use an email from SendGrid, and I'm going to say from equals new email. And this is going to be who I'm sending from. So again, you'll have to set this up on the SendGrid side. If you don't, you'll get an error when you try and send this off. So we're going to say to email is equal to new email. And this is whoever gets passed in as the argument to this message. We'll need to create some content. So content, content. This is from, again, SendGrid. So we'll say email content is equal to new content. So in this case, we're just going to send some text plain. You could use HTML email if you wanted. And then we're going to use the content that is passed into this method. Next, we'll get a mail. So mail is equal to new mail. And we're going to pass in the from, the subject, the to email, and the content. So content, and now we have what we need. So we have everything kind of set up. Now we need to configure the SendGrid client. So we can do that by saying SendGrid, SG is equal to new SendGrid, and we're just going to pass in that SendGrid API key. So we have that. And then we'll set up a request. So the request is equal to new request, right? And now that we have everything, let's go ahead and try this. Let's prepare the request. So we're going to say request.set method. And what is the method? This is going to be a post. So we have a post there. We got to set the endpoint. So the endpoint for this is going to be mail send, right? And then finally, we need to set the body. So set the body, and that is going to be mail.build, okay? And then we'll go ahead and add an exception here. And that is the IOO exception. Okay, so now that we've kind of got that request sent up, what are we going to do? We need to send it. So we're going to say response is equal to sendgrid.api, and we're going to pass in that request. So that is going to go ahead and send that off. And then I just want to do a little logging here. So we can actually just print this out to the console. So I'll say system out. Let's say the status code is equal to response. Dot status code. All right. What else can we print? Let's go ahead and print the body. So response.get body. Okay. And finally, let's print out any headers. Response headers. And that should print that out. Cool. Now I also want to catch an IO exception here. And we just want to go ahead and throw new IO exception. Failed to send email, exception.get message. Okay. So now we are in our send email, basically setting up some parameters, who we're going to send it to or from, who we're going to send it to, what is the content of the email. We're setting up a new mail object, which is part of the SendGrid API. Again, if this is new to you, you can take a look at the API docs. We set up a client, we set up a request, and then we go through and we set up the requests with some parameters, and then we go ahead and send that off with that request. We just log some things out, and then we are done here. So with that in place, now we can go back to our main method, our main class. And again, IntelliJ kind of just does some things to kind of set some things up for us. And what we want to do is we want to create an instance of that email service. So I'll say var email service is equal to new email service. And I'm going to set up a body using a multi-line string in Java. So now we can go ahead and kind of create our email here. So I'll say hello from SendGrid, and we'll do I am testing out the Java SDK for SendGrid, and this is a multi-line string in Java, right? And then we'll just say, thank you, Dan Vega. Cool. So now we have a body for the email. So now what I can do is I can say, let's go ahead and try this, because remember, in our email service, we throw an exception if something happens. So I'm going to try this. I'm going to say email service.sendEmail. Who am I going to send it to? I'm going to send it to my work email, so broadcom.com. What are we going to have as the subject? YouTube SendGrid tutorial. Okay. And then finally, what is the content? And we wrote that out there, the body. So we have the body there. And then we're just going to catch if something happens with that IO exception. We'll say E, and then we'll just E.printStackTrace. Okay, so everything looks pretty good here. Now we can go ahead and try and run this. So I'm going to go ahead and run this from IntelliJ by running the main method. And you see we get a status code of 202, a response body, response headers, and everything looks pretty good. So now I'm going to go back over to my work email and check that. Whoops, I put my wrong email in there. Sorry about that. I'm going to run that again, and everything looks okay now. And there we go. So YouTube SendGrid tutorial, hello from SendGrid, testing out the Java SDK for SendGrid, and this is a multi-line string in Java. Thank you, Dan Vega. And again, I don't know if it comes through on this video, but that was extremely fast. So that was it. A nice short tutorial today, but really easy to add email capabilities to your Java applications using SendGrid. And I want to stress that it's not just about sending mail, right? Like, you can use the Java Mail API to send an email, but sending email is not easy. Like, there are a lot of things that go into making sure that email is delivered, getting analytics around that stuff. There's a whole lot that goes into this, and I'm happy to use a service like SendGrid to make sure that those critical emails are getting through. So really happy with this service, really happy with how easy it is to get up and running. And again, I did this first because we will use this in at least one other video, maybe a couple others in the near future. So hey, I want to hear from you. How are you sending emails in your Java applications? Have you given SendGrid a trial run? Do you like what you see? Do you like what you're seeing here from SendGrid? Is this something that you will use in a future application? Either way, I hope that you learned something new today, folks. I love when you learn something new. That is why I'm here. If you did, do me a big favor. Leave me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. And as always, happy coding.